It's the year 1900 in the United Kingdom. People are walking silently down the street. Households are quiet. Women are having unwanted babies. And everywhere are unhappy marriages. Everyone is living in fear. No one dares to speak of the controversial topic. No one dares to say the word out loud. And I know what you're thinking. It's not Voldemort. No. The topic was sexual intercourse. No one dared to speak of it at that time. And they had no internet, no connection. So they couldn't go anywhere with their questions or looking for a book. But then one woman made a difference. And her name was Mindy Stokes. All right, so let's take this step by step. When you think about Mary Stokes, you probably think about this. That's right, nothing. You're probably thinking, who the heck is she? Well, don't you worry, because at the end of this video, I will have you convinced why you should vote for Mary Stokes as the most famous Briton of all time. Dear Mary Stokes, may I ask you a couple of questions?
Yeah, sure.
All right, at which university did you study?
I studied at the University College in London.
All right, and what subjects did you choose?
I did botany and geology.
She was born in Scotland in 1888 on the 15th of October. Growing up, she wanted to be a scientist, and thus she became one, and a very impressive one. She attended day and night classes and became the youngest person in Britain to earn a Doctor of Science degree. Not only did she become the youngest person of Britain ever to get that degree, but in the same year, she also became the first female faculty member at the University of Manchester. Mary Stokes was a very determined woman. She fought for her rights and listened to herself. She didn't let anyone get in her way. And I respect that immensely. Mary Stokes was a very strong woman. She has made many contributions to the science world with her work and research. But she wasn't only a scientist. So, Mary Stokes, what exactly is your take on equality between men and women?
Women don't need to listen to the men. We can make our own choices and decisions. We're equal. And if you don't think so, you can leave.
Mary Stokes was a woman rights activist. Her ideas of how marriage and equality should work were way ahead of her time. And she wasn't afraid to speak up about those ideas. In 1913, she published a book called Married Love. Her book Married Love or Love and Marriage was first published in March 1918 by Fitfield & Co., one of the smaller publishers, after several larger publishers had turned her book down because of the controversial content. The book was extremely influential and brought the topic of birth control out of the shadow. The book was rapidly sold out, even though it was banned by the church and other influential sources. The book argued that marriage should be an equal relationship between partners. Although the book was mostly frowned upon, the book went through 19 editions, with over a quarter million sold. Mary Stokes was a very firm believer in anticonceptional methods. She encouraged women to have children by choice and not by chance. This is an idea and a mindset that is still relevant in 2018. We are still dealing with a lot of unwanted pregnancies in the world. In the UK alone, there were 158,000 abortions in 2016. The way to decrease these numbers is through education and better use of anticonception. This discussion of how to do it and the best methods to use is a discussion that is still going on. And you could say that Mary Stokes has started this discussion. In 1921, Marie Stopes opened the first birth control clinic in the UK. There she offered advice and knowledge to married and poor women about the use of birth control and encouraged them to talk openly about sex. This is probably how it went.
Herb.
Yo, I don't think we should talk about this.
Come on, why not?
People might misunderstand what we're trying to say, you know?
No, but that's a part of life.
Now to the people at home or in the crowd, it keeps coming up anyhow. Don't decoy, avoid, or make void the topic, because that ain't gonna stop it.
Well, maybe not exactly like that, but you get the point. She was the first person in the UK to provide information like this to the open public, and of course she got some backlash for it, but it was nothing compared to the grace that she got for it. Within 2 weeks of publishing her book, she got showered in letters from thankful women asking for her advice. Marie believed that there were two things that needed to be fixed, and these were the reasons why she wrote the book. Let me show you in her own words.
I believe that two things have done more evil on earth than anything else. One is that married lovers have not known the rudiments of the fine art of making love. And it's so important. The other, the world is full of unwanted children. The social system is in a mess. The statesmen are trying to mop up the mess instead of turning off the tap which causes it.
Her book was even considered as one of the 25 most influential books of the past 50 years in 1995. Her book was alongside Albert Einstein's Relativity and Mein Kampf from Adolf Hitler. Alright, so let's recap now that you have heard her story. These should be the things that you think about when you hear the name Marie Stopes. She was a very successful scientist and she worked very hard. She wrote an extremely influential book that shocked the whole world. She made having a baby and a career more accessible for the woman. She decreased the number of unwanted pregnancies and made sex a more open topic to talk about.
So, do you have one last thing to say to the people of Britain?
Vote for Marie Stopes as the greatest Briton of all time. Go to www.votethegreatestbritain.com and choose Marie Stopes. Yeah!